morning, Trinidad and Tobago, and welcome to the Boss Report. Well, it's been a good weekend in terms of cricket, and today we're taking a look at the financial performance of two companies who had quite different performances over the past fiscal year, and we're talking about Grace Kennedy Corporation as well as Prestige Holdings Limited for the respective financial years ended December and November, respectively. Now, Grace Kennedy would have had a quite significantly improved performance, while Prestige Holdings would have faced some significant headwinds to performance over the past fiscal year. What would have accounted for some of these changes, and what can investors expect in the months ahead? Well, let's take a look. And turning firstly to Grace Kennedy Corporation, for that fiscal year ended December 2020, the group would have reported an earnings per share of 28 cents TT dollar equivalent, which was a quite impressive increase of 38.8% from the 20 cents recorded in the prior comparable period. Now, it was very nice green-lighted numbers all across the board. Revenues were up from overall just around 12% from $4.6 billion to $5.17 billion, as well as expenses being up just around 9.3%, so proportionately less than revenues from $4.45 to $4.866 billion. And profit before taxes would have increased overall from $274 to $455 million, a 58% increase, and that would have translated into profits attributable to shareholders of Grace Kennedy by that 38-odd% from 201 to 278 million. When we take a look at the profit before tax by segment, we see some very nice trends occurring in terms of that money services business. It would have increased by just around 28-odd% from 138 to 177-odd million dollars. And that was on the heels of increasing remittances, as well as some government business, particularly in Jamaica from the CARE program, where they would, Grace would have been one of the primary providers of remittance services or transfer services. We can see also in terms of banking and investments, down by just 9%, that in that pink segment, insurance had down, well, up actually around 20% from 37 to 45 million. And that food trading segment almost doubling, up 96% from 89 million to 174 million. So certainly, that trend of eating more at home and cooking more at home would have benefited Grace to some extent, as we would have seen with a local counterpart, Massey, in the conglomerate sector, where the integrated retail segment would have improved, as well as NFM on the manufacturing one sector, which would have also seen benefits from more home participation in terms of preparing food. We can see that Grace Kennedy would have had improved margins quite significantly after hovering at just around that 6.1% level. We can see that margins in terms of operating profits would have increased to around 8.5%, and profit before tax margins would have also increased from around the 6% handle to around 8.4%. So again, in terms of efficiency and translating every dollar of revenue earned into profits, either at the operating or profit before tax level, Grace Kennedy would have done a quite significantly better job in terms of that aspect in the fiscal 2020 period now concluded. So at a price of $4.50 TT dollars, and having advanced just around 17% year to date, Grace Kennedy is trading at a price earnings ratio of 16.1 times, which is above the sector average, the conglomerate sector average of 14.5 times, and offers investors a dividend yield of 1.6%, which again is below the sector average of 2% rather. So on that basis of elevated valuations, the quite increasingly attractive prospect of US dollar dividend payments, albeit at a fairly low 1.6% level, improving margins, but that sluggish economic recovery still putting the future performance of Grace Kennedy into some question. Boss is going to maintain a neutral rating at this point in time on Grace. Turning quickly to Prestige Holdings Limited, and for that fiscal period ended 2020, the group recorded a loss per share of 29 cents compared to that earnings per share of 58 cents in the prior comparable period. It doesn't make for quite pretty reading in this particular case, or in the case of Prestige for this fiscal year. Total revenues were down just around 19% from $1.1 billion to $896 million. Operating profits down a whopping 90% from $59.4 to $5.5 million. Finance costs increased on the back of IFRS 16 and lease-related accounting changes from 5.1 to 21.2 million over the differing fiscal years. And that would have led to a swing from a profit of 54.4 to a loss before tax of 15.7. After taxes, that was 17.7 million loss versus the 35.8 million profit in the prior comparable period. Now, quite a number of days of absolute closures and then very restricted service levels to adhere to COVID-19 protocols, there would have been quite significant decreases in revenue, and that certainly would have bucked the trend over the past couple of fiscal years for Prestige Holdings. We can see that in fiscal 2019, they would have recorded a 6.8% revenue growth. That would have been, of course, derailed by a 19.4% decline in revenues to that $897 odd million in fiscal 2020. Now, with the normalization of operations, and we use that term loosely, there should be a recovery, at least partially, in fiscal 2021 on the revenue side of things. When we take a look at margins, well, Prestige has done a reasonably good job in terms of cost of sales management, with that gross profit margin hovering still around the 33% level, so in line with historical trends. The operating profit margin and profit before tax margin would have been impacted by a couple one-offs and some accounting changes. Some of those would have been the impairment of goodwill related to its Subway franchise, as well as that lease-related account, you know, IFRS 16, which would have certainly changed the dynamic on an ongoing basis in our view in terms of how leases are accounted for, and that would, of course, change the profit before tax margin, operating profit margin, to some extent in subsequent periods for Prestige Holdings, as well as other companies that would be affected. So at a price of $7.70, but recording that loss per share, well, there's a negative price earnings ratio. So that really is not a reasonable comparison to the sector average of 18.7 times. Prestige does offer a dividend yield of 0.8%, having declared a somewhat reduced dividend. But again, it's a little bit below the sector average of 2.7%. So with that normalization of operations, which should lead to some partial recovery, but again, with sluggish economic prospects for the Trinidad and Tobago jurisdiction in particular, BOS is going to maintain a neutral rating on Prestige Holdings for the time being. But that's it for this week's edition. For more information, give us a call at 226-8773. Email us at invest@bosfinancial.com or check out our website at bosinvestment.com. May all of our research is absolutely free. And of course, you can catch us in today's business section of the Bigger Better Trinidad and Tobago Guardian newspaper. Until next time, this has been the Bosch Report. Have yourselves a wonderful investing week.